Game continues in Stockton tonight. To dive into this a little bit deeper, we're going to bring in CBS 13 political analyst Gary Dietrich. So, Gary, this caught a lot of people off guard last night. What's your take on the Stockton's mayor race?
Well, I think it is a surprise, Adrian, especially when you look at they use the word star power, Renee did in her report, and there's a lot of truth to that. But when it comes to a city the size of Stockton, who's traditionally had so many issues over the years with crime, with poverty, now with homelessness, certainly with COVID and the age we're in now, you know, people want, as they like to say, they like to have their potholes fixed. They want the light, the street lights to work. And it's those real grassroots kind of things, the things that people experience every day that they really ultimately judge a mayor on, not honestly whether an Oprah or a Barack Obama endorses them.
Gary, let's talk election patterns from our local counties, Placer County specifically, usually leans red. This election, it turned blue. More people voted for Biden in that county than Trump. Are we just going to chalk that up? Do you think Bay Area transplants moving into Placer County?
Well, there's certainly some of that, Tony, and there's no question that that whole part of the Sacramento region has been exploding, new housing, and we know certainly even this year there's been a mass exodus from the Bay Area. Real estate agents around the region will tell you this all over. There's been a mass exodus from LA and especially the Bay Area to our area, and certainly that plays a big role in it. And Placer County's been moving that direction for some time, and it looks like perhaps we'll see if it continues that it's accelerating.
All right. Finally here, Gary, let's talk mail-in voting. It kind of appears to be the new normal for elections here in California. So how do you think it could change how campaigns actually run here in the state?
Well, Adrian, the biggest part about it is banking votes. That's the political term that's been used for years for getting those absentee or mail-in ballots turned in early. We're seeing that play out now on a national level. But it really started with local campaigns where the thought was, let's get as many people turn those ballots early so we don't have to knock on doors on election night. I think we're going to see this increase. Hey, the state just north of us, Oregon, did an all mail-in election this time around. And I wouldn't be surprised to see mail-in balloting in California continue at a strong pace going forward.
One last question. How much sleep did you get last night?
Listen, Tony, a full 30 minutes. I want you to know that. I was up early this morning. We'll be again tomorrow. Hey, that's the nature of elections, my friend. You know that.
Perfect. Running on adrenaline. There you go. All right, Gary, thanks so much for your insight. As always, we'll see you again here soon.